Okay, so I don't want to harp on this too much, but just sort of a thing to point out why the world building in this anime is really bad. At one point, Soulburner and Flame, while being in the internet, see some planes move, and they're like, "Wait, how do these planes move? They must be ghost planes." You're in the internet! You are literally in a fictional world! Within the fictional world you exist in, like, just move the planes with internet stuff. Why? God. Anyways, so yeah. Apart from that, I quite liked what happened here. It was actually very interesting and sort of a different take on the whole aspect with the Ignises. For starters, and I know we've brought this up multiple times, the Ignises are probably the most interesting things in this series. I think their personalities are very well done. I think their concepts are very interesting, and all of them always bring this nice uniqueness that I think this show needs wherever they're on screen. And one aspect Windy brings to this is that Windy is actually a lot like I, but sort of backwards. Like, and I know this is with Flame and Lightning, respectively. And I guess you could make the argument Earth and Aqua are very opposite personalities as well. But getting back to the ones we really got to talk about. So, with I and Windy, I and Windy are the most playful of them. Like, they are the both most dedicated to wanting to have fun. They're very big personalityed. They're very much sort of attention seekers. But what's sort of interesting is that I chooses to have a conscience. I chooses to believe in right and wrong. Even though, as we've seen at a couple points in the show, he's not always going to be 100% one or the other. He is, at his core, a good guy with morals. Windy is actually the direct opposite, and that is Windy, or maybe not direct opposite, that would imply a different personality, but it's like, it's this idea that Windy has all that too, that childlike innocence, a desire for fun and whimsy, but he's in the direction of Lightning, and that is that burn them motherfuckers. Like Windy's whole aspect in this, he doesn't seem to have a greater ideology. He doesn't seem to have a desire for the Ignises to reign supreme. It really feels like all Windy cares about is just wanting to believe for his own ego that he doesn't need a partner, or that he's better than the other Ignises, or that he just wants revenge on Revolver. There's no greater thing going on here, and that's kind of interesting because, as we saw in this episode, because Windy has no bigger plan or any greater beliefs outside of just what he feels like at that moment, he'll go further than any of the others will. Like Lightning, everything he does, everyone he sacrifices is all part of a bigger plan. Windy just killed his partner because it just like seemed like the guy kind of pissed him off. Like, look at Windy's face in that flashback when we see what his partner looked like. Look at Windy, he's almost got anger. He's almost got this hatred towards the guy. It's a very fast shot, but I feel like it says everything. And there's a lot you can wonder about Windy's personality. Does it piss Windy off that he came from a human? Is there maybe some guilt within Windy that they were created from such a horrible incident? And the fact that Windy's then first response is off the motherfucker. And yeah, some people, when we first learned about Windy's partner in the car accident, wondered, well, it's Yu-Gi-Oh! They won't always go off and kill the guy. No, Windy fucking murdered this kid shit. It was actually really cool. And it's just sort of that idea that what makes Windy dangerous is he's impulsive. He will do things like set up a big trap that people will then get stuck into, like when we first met him. Even if that could potentially get people to find out about you, he don't care because he just kind of does whatever he wants, and that's why he's scary. And I love the way he sort of contradicts with Flame's personality, because Flame is sort of this very, a lot like Lightning in that he is very thinking, he is very deep, he's very contemplative, not very emotional, not always necessarily letting people in on what's going through his head. And that sort of makes it interesting when you see these two duel, because Flame is very much, we have responsibilities, we have to be grateful for our partners, to our partners, we have certain things we have to do, and Windy being told he has some level of obligation to somebody else pisses him off more than anything else. He even seems more pissed off at Flame for saying that than he is at Revolver for Swiss cheesing his ass. So that is really interesting to me. Like, it really is a good concept, and it really is an interesting idea. And yeah, I quite liked it. Not much else to say. This was pretty simple, but it's a nice simple concept, and the fact that you can infer so much from these characters who really we don't, like, they're computer programs, yet somehow they end up being more interesting than any other people. But in the comment section below, give me your thoughts on this episode, on the Ignis's personalities, and if you like what they're doing with Wendy. As for the TCG question of the week, Luna Lights won a YCS. Lord, and they won like the shittiest YCS ever, where nature itself was trying to end it. Like, that was crazy. But one of the big questions going up, well, did he really win because of Luna Lights and their ability to just OTK, or did he mostly win just due to Azathoth? Because the guy flat out says in the profile, just the power of Azathoth, and as we saw from a lot of the other top tier decks, Azathoth pretty much wins games, especially in the way it's being used, being able to use it on the opponent's turn. So my question to you is, do you think it was mostly Azathoth? Or do you think it was the fact that he definitely designed the deck for getting anything he needs to out of the way so he can OTK with the Luna Lights? Personally, I actually think it's the second option. If I'm correct, Leo Dancer, the big one, actually has targeting protection, similar to how a lot of boss monsters at the time were getting it. So obviously, it's got a good Sky Striker matchup, it's got a good Altergeist matchup, it's got a good Thunder Dragon matchup. And then you just use the Kaijus and the Danger Engine in order to just fill in the blanks. Tell me what you think about that below. And as always, click to like, click to subscribe, and join me next week as we see more of a deck that consists of weird whale, bird, plane things. Also, Lightning's ace monster is an elephant. Where are we going with this?